Hi everyone, it's Emma from MSC Makes and this is a tutorial on how to crochet a mini solid granny hexagon and how to join as you go to create a really beautiful scrap yarn blanket. For this tutorial I'm going to be using some leftover sock yarn and I'll be using that with a 3.5mm hook. You can use any yarn that you prefer for this pattern, but just remember that you'll need to adjust your hook size accordingly. Please note that I'm based in the UK and therefore I use UK crochet terminology. This pattern only uses a single stitch, which is a UK treble crochet, and this is equivalent to a US double crochet. To get started, I'll be showing you how to crochet a full hexagon, and then after that, I'll be showing you how to join the other remaining hexagons as you go. To begin, you'll need to create a slip knot. And I'm just going to pop that on my hook and create a chain circle by chaining four and joining with a slip stitch by going through the very first chain there. And if you prefer, you can use a magic loop or a magic circle. And if you do want to use a chain circle but find it tricky to find the center gap, what you can do is chain five or even six so that the hole's a bit bigger in the center, and then we can just close that up when you sew in the end when you've finished. To begin our first round, I'm going to chain four again, and this counts as our first stitch plus our corner chain space. And what we need to do in this first round is to create our six clusters here in the middle, which will become the six sides of the hexagon. And we've already created half of one of the clusters here with this chain. So to begin, I'm going to work two trebles into the center of that circle. I'll just bring the camera a little bit closer. And to do that, you'll need to yarn over, insert your hook into the center there, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through two, and yarn over and pull through two. So again, we're going to yarn over, insert our hook into the center, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through two, and yarn over and pull through two. And that's our first cluster completed there. And then we need to chain two for our corner space. And we need to do this four more times. So we're going to yarn over, insert our hook, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two again. And then we need to create another treble. So yarn over, insert your hook, yarn over and pull through, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two again, and then chain two again for our next corner. So I'm going to carry on going round now. So I'm going to create another two trebles into the center, followed by a chain two space. And if at any point you get a bit lost or lose count, you can just stop and just count how many clusters you've done, so that I can see here that I've done one, two, and three. So I need to keep going and add another cluster. And then finally, our fifth cluster by working two trebles into the center there. We're going to chain two, and we've come back around to the beginning now, and this starting chain here, remember, counts as one stitch, which is half of our last cluster. So we're going to create one treble this time, and then we're going to join to the third chain in that starting chain there with a slip stitch. So if we just stop now, it's always worth stopping and having a little count just to make sure you've got the correct amount. One, two, three, four, five, and six. It is incredibly easy to do either one too many or not enough and end up with a very strange looking hexagon at the end of it. And then just to complete this first round, we're going to slip stitch very loosely into that chain space there. And I'm just going to bring this a bit closer so I can show you what we're going to be doing in the following rounds. We're basically going to be building on that initial round there. So if you can see, we've got two treble crochet stitches in this first round. In the second round, we've got four stitches because we work one either side and then one stitch into the tops of those previous stitches. And then in the third round, we've got one either side again, plus one stitch into the tops of those previous stitches, which gives us six stitches in total. So you're going up in twos on each side of the hexagon, 2, 4, and 6. So I'm going to demonstrate how to do that now. Just like last time, we're going to chain four to begin. And then we're going to work one treble into this chain space. We then need to work a treble into the top of each of these stitches here. So into our first one, and then into the next stitch. And then we need to work a treble crochet stitch on the other side of that cluster. So we go into the chain two space, just work another treble, and then just like before, we're going to chain two. So on that side, we've now got our four stitches. So this chain here that we did at the beginning counts as one of the side stitches there. So again, on this side, we're going to work a treble into that corner space, a treble into each of those two stitches from the previous round, and then one treble on the other side. And then we'll chain two to create our next corner. And remember, just a little reminder, I'm using UK terminology. If you are used to using US terminology, you'll want to be working double crochets. They're the same thing, they've just got different names. It's all very confusing. Okay, so I'm just going to continue working my way around. I'll do that so you can see what I'm doing. So one treble here, a treble into each of the stitches, and a treble on the other side in that corner space. Oops. Chain two again, a treble into that corner space, work one stitch into the top of each of those stitches from the previous round. One more treble on the other side into that next corner space, chain two, and we're almost back at the beginning. We've got to work our first stitch on the side and then our next stitch into the top of the stitch from the previous round. And now this one can look a little tricky because we've got a slip stitch here and then the chain coming up out of it, and it can be a bit difficult to know where to pop your hook. But if you just pop it on a side like this, can see the next stitch is here. And if you have made your slip stitch too tight, it can be a bit tricky to get your hook in here, but if you try and do it quite loosely, you should find that your hook goes through nice and easily. I'll just work a treble crochet again, and then just like before, we're going to join to the beginning of the round with a slip stitch through the third chain from the bottom. And then again, slip stitch into that corner space. And we've now completed two of our rounds. So I'm just going to work one more round and then we will have completed our first hexagon. So just like before, chain four, which counts as a stitch plus a corner space. And then exactly the same, just one treble crochet into that chain space, a treble crochet into each of these stitches from the previous round. So this time we're going to be working four. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then one stitch either side, remember. So we do another stitch into that chain space, and then that gives us a total of 6 stitches. And then we just need to chain two, to create our next space. And then again, a treble crochet into that corner space, a treble crochet into each of those stitches from the previous round. And then a treble crochet into the next corner space. So we've got our four trebles plus one either side to give us a total of six. So I'm just going to go and quickly work my way around now, just to show you how to finish off. And then I will be showing you how to join them as you go. So if you like, you can add more rounds to your hexagons. You don't have to do them just as three rounds. And if you wanted to do that, you would continue adding them in exactly the same way. So that would be one stitch into each one from the previous round before with one either side. So with each round, each side of the hexagon increases by two. I'm sorry if you can hear that. We've got an aeroplane going over outside. Okay, so now I'm almost back around to the beginning on the final side, and very similar to, well, exactly the same as before. I've just worked my one treble crochet here into the chain space, and then I'm going to work one stitch into each of those trebles from the previous round. But remember that the last one can look a little bit different because the way we've slip stitched. So if I bring it close again, you should be able to see we've got a nice gap there to work into. And if you look at it from the top, that should become more obvious. I'll just work my final treble into there. We don't need to work a treble on the other side because we've already got one from our starting chain. And we just join with a slip stitch into the third chain from the bottom, slip stitch into that corner space, and then you can cut your yarn and then just pull the end through. And that gives you your very first hexagon. And then after this, all of your other hexagons can join onto this one. So next I'm going to show you how to join as you go. And I've got a hexagon here that I've already started. So to join as you go, you'll need to complete a hexagon to the end of the second round. And then you'll join it as you work the third round. And when you first start off, you'll just be joining it along one side, but most often, once you start adding to the blanket, you'll be joining along two sides, or sometimes, as you can see here, you'll be joining along three sides, and it's exactly the same method whichever one you're doing. So what I like to do is complete the first side of my hexagon before I start to join. So I'm going to do that now by chaining four, working a treble crochet into that chain space, work a treble crochet into each of the next four stitches, and then work another treble crochet into that corner space. And then instead of chaining two, I'm just going to chain one. I'm going to pull up a loop and pinch that, whoops, between my thumb and finger just to stop it pulling out. And then I'm going to start joining, and I'm going to do that, I think I'll join it over here next to this blue. So you want to get your blanket with your hexagon that you've already created, and I want to join along this side. Let me try and hold it a bit flatter. Along this side and then back up this side. And what I'll need to do that is join it into this corner space here. So I'm going to do so by popping my hook through from the top to the bottom. I'm going to grab that loop, just pull it a little bit tight so that you can pull it through. And then I'm going to chain one to secure it. And then we're going to continue working this next side of the hexagon here. So I'm going to work a treble crochet. I'm going to stop, going to grab that loop, and then I'm going to pop my hook through the top of the corresponding stitch on this hexagon, which is this one here. So again, from top to bottom, you pop your hook underneath both loops of that stitch, grab the loop and pull it through. And then we need to work our next stitch. So now we're going into the top of the stitch from the previous round. We're going to work a treble crochet, grab that loop, remove our hook, pop it through the next stitch from the top to the bottom, grab the loop again, pull it tight and pull it through. We'll work our next stitch, grab the loop, pop our hook through the next stitch on the hexagon that we're joining to from top to bottom, grab the loop again, pull it tight and pull it through. Work our next stitch, grab the loop, the hook goes through the next stitch that we're joining to, grab the loop, pull it tight and pull it through. Work our next stitch, grab the loop, pop our hook through, put the loop back on, pull it tight and pull it through. And we've just got one more stitch left to do on this side now. It can be a little bit awkward when it starts getting bigger. Normally when I crochet this, I find it helpful to rest this on something, even like my knee or something as I'm crocheting it, or a table. So I'm going to work my final treble crochet into that space there. Grab the loop, pop your hook through and pull it through that stitch in the same way. Then what I like to do is chain one, and now we want to start joining onto this next hexagon here. So we've just joined it, let me hold it so you can see, we've just joined it along this hexagon, along this side here, and now we want to continue and join it on this side here. So after you've done that chain one, what you want to do is pop your hook through this corner space here of the next hexagon, and then just grab that loop and pull it through in exactly the same way, and then just chain one again to secure it. We're going to work our first stitch on that next side, and then we're going to pop our hook through the corresponding stitch here. And if you find it tricky, you can always count backwards. So remember, in this final side, we should have six stitches, so we can count back here. So here's the corner space, and we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we know that we need to be popping our hook through this space here, and just pull that loop through. And then continue working the third round of that hexagon. And after each stitch, you're going to just grab hold of that loop, pop your hook through the one that you're joining to, and pull the loop through. So work the next stitch, grab the loop, hook goes through from top to bottom, grab the loop, and pull it back through. And let me try and do one so I'm holding it really closely so you can see. So I'm going to work our next stitch, grab that loop to stop it pulling through, pop the hook through there, grab the loop again, pull it tight and pull it through. We've got one more stitch left on this side. I'm going to pop my hook through that final stitch and pull the loop through. And then again, just to finish off that side, I like to chain one, and I'm going to pop my hook through that corner space at the end here, pull that loop through and chain one again. And that creates the corner, and it just makes things look a little bit neater and a bit easier as well. And then we just need to continue working our hexagon. We're all joined now, so we can just finish off our hexagon as we were doing before by working one treble into that corner space, a treble into each stitch along, another one on the other side into that chain space, chain two, and work another treble, work a treble crochet into the next 4 stitches. And then another one into that corner space. And we're almost back at the beginning now. So we're going to chain 2. We're ready to complete this side. Work a treble crochet into that corner space. Work a treble crochet into the next 4 stitches. And again, remember that that last stitch can look a little bit different. But again, if you look at it from the top, it should make it a lot clearer where you're working into. Just remember to keep your slip stitches nice and loose. And then to finish off, we're going to join to the beginning of the round by popping our hook through that third chain from the bottom and join with a slip stitch, and then just slip stitch into that corner again. And then what you would do is cut that yarn. Whoops. And just pull that end through there. And there you go. So you've just finished creating that hexagon and you've joined it as you go to the other hexagons there. And it creates this really beautiful kind of twirl effect. And it's nice and stretchy as well, as you can see. So I hope you found that tutorial helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate it if you would like and subscribe. And leave me a comment and let me know if there's any other tutorials you'd like to see in the future. And take care, everyone, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.